Hey guys, welcome to this first video in a series of tutorials on management information systems for development and humanitarian program monitoring. My name is Rob Myers and I'll be presenting these tutorials. First off, the course overview. This video is all about the why of management information systems. Basically, what we're going to do is we're going to compare the old way of doing things with the new way and see what are the benefits and advantages of leveraging the latest technology and software in order to do a better job. Second video, becoming familiar with the ComCare project space. In this video, I'm going to help you set up your own ComCare project space, as well as just give you an overview of the different functionalities that there are and that we can see from the ComCare home screen. Third video will be setting up BlueStacks. So BlueStacks is an Android emulator that we frequently use for testing our applications as well as data entry from the comfort of our own laptops. Then a short introduction to Power BI. Power BI is dashboard software that we use for our analytics. And then we're going to get our hands dirty. We're going to create a super simple application in ComCare. After that, we're going to test our super simple application, and then we'll be exporting our data and create a super simple dashboard in Power BI. So just to give you a really quick overview of what that would look like, in ComCare, we're going to build a form such as this one, including a number of very simple questions. Then in BlueStacks, we will be testing our application, such as here. And finally, in Power BI, we're going to create a super simple dashboard, which will show us some key figures from our application. So now onto the why of management information systems. And it's a good question. I mean, for the past 30 years, we've been reasonably successful at collecting and analyzing data for our programs, right? So why should we even bother about using all these new technologies and softwares? Well, hopefully this comparison will give you a bit of a better idea and present some arguments for why every single organization should be using the latest in technology and software to make their information systems better. Okay, so let's first look at the old way of doing things. In a typical example, we might have four different field sites all collecting data. This could be either for a survey or routine monitoring. And they're collecting this data using pen and paper. And when they hand over that data to the field offices, someone enters the data into an Excel file, for example. Then using this Excel file, the data is aggregated, usually into a separate Excel file, and is sent via email to the country office. The country office then consolidates the data from these different field sites, does a bit of cleaning, and then uses that data to do the analyses. Then to HQ, a Word document might be sent with the results of these analyses, and it's always a question whether or not the field sites receive or get any feedback of those final analyses, as is often assumed that, well, they've entered and aggregated the data, so they must know what's going on. There are some exceptions to this. So sometimes, we might go straight from the data collection to the data aggregation stage. So there is no digital copy of the raw data. And this actually happens quite often. So think, for example, a training register. We usually wouldn't enter all that data into Excel, but we would just have a summary sheet of total number of people attended and then gender breakdown, average age. And in some cases, data is collected and then just simply filed away after it has been looked at by a project manager or someone else at the field level. So what's different with the new way of working? Well, first of all, in most of the field sites, we would be using mobile devices, so either mobile phones or tablets with ComCare loaded onto them. This data is then either immediately sent to a server using mobile data, or alternatively, it is sent at a later stage when the enumerators get to the field office and use the Wi-Fi to send the data to the ComCare servers. In some cases, of course, we still have to rely on using pen and paper due to maybe security concerns. But even so, when this data has been manually deliver to the field office, we would still use BlueStax, our Android emulator, to enter that data using ComCare and then send it straight to the ComCare servers. So notice that the data entry steps have almost been completely eliminated, and the data aggregation steps have, in actual fact, been completely eliminated. This is because we can do our analyses on the raw data itself. And there's just no need for aggregation anymore. In terms of cleaning and consolidation, this is to a large degree automated due to the validation placed on the forms. And the consolidation, because we're all using the same forms in the different field sites, this consolidation is done automatically. Finally, for the analysis, at all three levels, we are using Power BI. And the great thing about Power BI, and particularly the drill down functionality, which we're going to be discussing at a later stage, means that we can actually have the exact same dashboard for all three levels. So HQ might be receiving data sets from all around the world. Then the country offices can drill down into those data sets and filter by their own country to see how they compare with the rest of the organization. And finally, the field sites can do the same, see how they compare to the different field sites, see how they compare to the country average, and even see how do their field sites compare to the organizational average. Okay, so let's first take a step back here. Information systems are not meant to supplant or replace core monitoring, evaluation, accountability, or learning activities. They can, however, greatly contribute to the way in which these activities are carried out. This is true across the information chain, which includes data collection, data storage and management, and analytics. These stages of data management are enhanced in a number of ways, namely quality, efficiency, and security. Here we see our information chain in the context of the wider MIO activities. So step one, before the information chain actually starts, is project conceptualization. In this phase, we ask pertinent questions such as, what are we going to measure? How are we going to measure it? What are we trying to achieve with collecting the data, etc., etc. It's where we determine what are our indicators and what is our monitoring plan. Then the fifth step, data interpretation and reporting. So the preceding step, data analysis, that's great. We can create a bunch of fancy graphs and have a bunch of numbers show up on our screen, but the most crucial step is actually interpreting that data. So what does this mean? Is it different from the previous month or the previous year? Is this data different from other regions where we might not be working? So again, like, what does this data really mean? And then explain this to either our headquarters, to the donors, or back to the beneficiaries. Now, information systems are of limited, I wouldn't say use, but they have a limited capacity to aid in the first and fifth steps. However, within the information chain, so from the moment of data collection to data analysis, this is really where information systems can really benefit the way we work. Data collection. ODK-based data collection platforms make it easy to digitize forms and load them onto mobile phones. First of all, in terms of security, data collected on phones is encrypted with a username and password. This means that if somebody managed to get hold of your phone who isn't authorized to do so, it is impossible for them to retrieve the information on it unless they have your username and password. In addition, data can be sent straight to a server using encryption. This means that you automatically have a backup the moment you submit your form. In terms of quality then, data validation at the point of entry means data is more consistent across submitted forms and data entry errors are minimized. If you've ever been involved in consolidating and cleaning data from different field sites, you'll notice that although it's possible to add data validation to Excel files, usually people find a way of messing with the entire format of the Excel file, or add text where there's only supposed to be numbers, use different date formats. all these kind of things are avoided by using an ODK-based data collection platform. Then, as well, in terms of quality, geo and time tracking give feedback about the quality and diligence of enumerators. Being able to track when an enumerator starts their survey and when they end tells a lot about the quality of the survey carried out. Then, case management functionality allows entities to be tracked across multiple forms, allowing easier identification of unique beneficiaries. Trying to track, for example, 70,000 farmers over time using pen and paper and human-generated ID codes is a very difficult thing to do. And so using ODK-based DDG platforms makes this a lot easier. In terms of efficiency then, data is immediately digitized, so there's no need for data entry. As I said, we eliminated that data entry process, so we save a lot of man hours. Then changes to the form can be easily downloaded. If we make changes at the country office level, for example, and we need to push this out to the different field sites, this is very easily done using software such as ComCare, and it means you don't have to reprint all of the surveys. Data storage and management then. Data storage and management includes data entry, data aggregation, and cleaning and consolidation. Most digital data gathering platforms offer cloud-based data storage services, whereas in the old way of working, we would have our data distributed over possibly multiple laptops in different Excel files and emails. So in terms of security, we can already see huge benefits of from using DDG platforms. Data is secured with at-rest encryption and is only accessible with the correct username and password. In addition to this, multiple backups on distributed servers ensure that data is safe from being physically destroyed, such as in a fire. Then in terms of quality, data entry errors from paper to digital are avoided, and reduction in errors through automatic consolidation of data from multiple devices. And that's what we've seen here, because these two steps are virtually eliminated. There's also less risk of making errors within these steps. In terms of efficiency then, data is stored in analysis-friendly tabular formats rather than data entry-friendly spreadsheets. If you've ever worked with data in the field and have had to do your own data entry, you'll know that data entry forms that mimic the paper forms are a lot easier to work with than these tabular formats. But then once you get to the analysis stage, you need to do a lot of manipulation and cleaning before you get it into a format that makes it easy to analyze this data. Also in terms of efficiency, data is easily accessible for those with the correct credentials. Now, this might sound a bit at odds with the security issue we just mentioned, but at the same time, it means we're not beholden to the field for sending us information. So if we have a donor report due in 2 days and we need quick access to that data, we don't have to wait for the field levels to enter that data, then aggregate it and send it to us. We have direct access to it. And again, that data entry process has just been eliminated altogether, making everything a lot more efficient. So data analysis. Dashboard technology can be used to automate analyses and create interactive reports, allowing users to explore the data and identify meaningful trends and occurrences. Now, in terms of security, again, you need a username and password in order to access reports. So this is a recurring trend in the new way of working. You basically do not have access to any of the data unless you have the correct credentials. Data integrity is secured through performing analyses directly on the raw data. This again is something that is often overlooked as a huge advantage to using DDG platforms. The fact that we can trace the analyses back to the raw data rather than aggregated data means it's a lot more difficult for field teams to manipulate the data in some way that makes the results seem more preferable to them. And data remains on the cloud and is therefore less vulnerable to hacking or theft. In terms of quality, dynamic graphs make it easier to analyze data across multiple variables compared to static graphs in traditional reports. So in Power BI, once we have our graphs set up, if I click on my gender pie chart, for example, all of the other graphs on my dashboard will update or filter according to the gender that I clicked. This means that we can fit a lot more data onto a single screen and compare it to the old static graphs, in which we would have to make a separate graph for every single disaggregation. Then another quality point is drill down functionality makes it easy to spot and investigate potential issues with either the data or the progress towards an indicator itself. So this is another great functionality from Power BI, is this drill down functionality. So anyone at any level can basically use the same dashboard, and it makes it easy to basically show, if you're working in, you know, 1,000 villages, you might want to first aggregate those the results from those villages by chiefdoms or districts, and then you have a quick overview of, hey, you know, which districts are or aren't doing well, and then you can drill down into those districts to see, well, which particular villages are the problem villages. Then, in terms of efficiency, data can be piped directly from the servers to the dashboards every 24 hours. Again, we're cutting man hours by being able to do this. So the moment data is entered into a mobile device, it can then be refreshed within a 24-hour period, and same for our Power BI dashboards. They can also be refreshed. Once an analysis has been carried out in Power BI, the data manipulation steps are stored in a query and automatically applied to new incoming data. This again is another great functionality from Power BI, because it means that we can create our application, test it, then use that test data to build out our Power BI dashboard. And so that means when we start collecting real data, we have our dashboard set up, and with the ability to refresh every 24 hours, we're basically seeing the analyses in real time. And since that data cleaning and formatting only needs to be carried out once, an opportunity is created to perform more in-depth analyses. So we might start with a dashboard that simply just shows the results for our logFrame indicators on a 24-hour basis, so near real time. And once the project managers and grant managers, for example, have become accustomed to being able to use, you know, the results from these analyses, they might want to perform more in-depth analyses. So, you know, correlations, they might start asking questions of, well, why is this data showing the results that it is showing? You can review these points in the PowerPoint that has been attached to this course. In the next video, we'll be looking at how to set up a Common Care project space, as well as give a brief overview of the functionalities of Common Care.